Say roll around, sitting on doves, can't lie, I was high on shrubs.
Hey guys, welcome to Cine Topical. Nate here with Strange Wing, and today we're reacting to the official trailer for Netflix's Jingle Jangle, A Christmas Journey.
Once upon a time, lived the greatest inventor that ever there was, Jeronicus Jangle.
Merry Christmas indeed!
Jangle, for the last 30 years, you've been promising something sensational and more time. Either come up with the money you've borrowed by Christmas, or show me the revolutionary invention you once promised.
I would lose everything.
What's wrong, Grandpa?
Had a perfect life. Loving family. And a magical shop. Till an old friend took it all. But he didn't get this.
There's a huge age gap there.
About your grandfather, but something sensational in that.
You do, the magic lives inside of you.
Now have the decency to release this in December. They gotta release it in November. Now, this is a very mutual feeling, I feel like, between me and Jingle Jangle. I'm not gonna watch it. It doesn't want me to watch it. It's not made for me.
That's fair.
I will not be watching this film because I don't even celebrate Christmas. Nor does this look entertaining to me. Not saying it's gonna be a bad movie. It's not for me.
You dig?
So my thing is, there are a lot of elements of that that I liked.
Really?
Elements. I think that there was a good movie in there somewhere. I don't think that it's what we're going to get, final product. And it's literally exactly what you were saying. This is 100% made for children, which is fine, and they will probably love it. And if I had kids, I would watch it with them. But I love musicals. And a lot of the things that were in there, they felt like they just kind of had some of that like early 90s film magic in them. And I picked up on it immediately. Like some of like the adventure elements of there, all I could think about was Hook. And there's just a lot of that in there that reminded me of that. But like how I feel about most movies these days, there's just like, and this even had a modest, some might even say a meager amount compared to other movies, but the CGI that they went with in it just kind of killed it for me. And I feel like if they scaled this back a little bit and took some of the elements that would have needed that out, it would have been something that even I enjoyed as a 30-year-old man.
You're old!
Again, it's not for me, and that's okay. So,
let's think about these Netflix films. Like, even something like The Irishman, I've seen people deepfake that looked better than what was in The Irishman. Not saying The Irishman was a bad movie. I loved The Irishman. But all these Netflix movies, they're like, people is going to watch it because it's easy access.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I feel like they don't put the correct amount of money into them, especially when it comes to the effects.
From a business standpoint, I think they put the perfect amount of money in.
Well, that makes sense.
Because the same amount of people are going to watch it, so why would they spend the extra money?
To me, this is art, and film is art, and this, like you said, maybe if the CGI was better, it could have saved it.
Yeah.
But it feels like all these films, if it's got CGI in it, I'm immediately turned off because none of the CGI looks good. Something like Project Power, full of CGI, you knew it was full of CGI when you bought the script, and it was like, oh, we can get the CGI effects from 2005 for 40% off? Take those. So, you heard what we said. What do you say? I don't know. Tell us down in the comments section. Scroll back up, hit the like button, share the video.
And
subscribe.